Good afternoon, everyone. This is 287. And to all the Sabbath keepers out there, I hope you're having a happy and blessed Sabbath today. Now, I'm not going to speak on the current topic of discussion, which is Chick-fil-A and its owner and his position on his biblical beliefs. I'm going to go back a week or so and discuss the same thing, but in terms of how it relates to Penn State and that situation. One thing we have to understand that all this is about worship and who you worship, how you worship, and what you believe. It doesn't matter. We're always presented with great object lessons, and for those who are in the Word, you can see how it correlates to what the Word is telling us. And those who don't even give it a second thought, you need to start viewing these things in terms of what the Scripture say. How does this relate to Scripture? Things are no different now than they were thousands of years ago. The people and the things around us have changed, but the situations are identical. We're always being presented with object lessons, and we need to learn from them, or we can end up in the same predicaments. Over and over and over, it happens. So, with that being said, here we go. Okay, look, we're going to start with 1 Timothy 6:10, and it reads, "For the love of money is the root of all evil, which, while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows." Okay, now, this applies in this regard. When people are coveting money, fame, success, popularity, titles, things that benefit them, that selfish wanting, they fall into this. It's not just dollars and cents, but this is what the Scripture says, for the love of money, or for the love of this type of gain, is the root of all the evil that befalls us. Now, let's talk about Penn State. Joe Paterno was very successful. He had a lot of fame, he had fortune, money, popularity, all these things. In fact, to a point that people literally worshiped him. Now, having all this surrounding you, people worshiping you, having you up on a pedestal, having a statue of you that people were worshiping, if that has no chance of getting to your ego, you're a better man than any of us are. But the examples are there for themselves. They all got caught up in that. Joe Paterno, the school, university, Penn State, the university, the people, the community, all got caught up in this. They're worshiping the individual, worshiping that statue, worshiping the name of Penn State and all that it stood for, all the success and fame and popularity and fortune that it had brought that way. The community all got caught up in that to a point of ignoring and doing what's right and obeying what the Father says. That became such a distraction that simple things got ignored. Now, I'm referring to the Sandusky thing. If individuals in that had done what was right, if they worshiped the right way, if they were focused on the right things, they would have turned away from the things that they honored and worshiped and cherished most and would have taken care of the little things. See, they were focused on image, popularity, namesake, community, and all these things, and they protected it to their demise. See, the enemy is going to let this stuff run rampant for as long as he deems fit, and then he will pull the carpet from under and it will all come crashing down. It starts with individuals like Joe Paterno. Something like this happens, and then everyone starts to try and sweep it under the rug to minimize it. instead of doing the right thing, because they already understand that it is going to bring a black eye on all that they cherish: name, fame, popularity, the university, the community. So it starts at the bottom, and the cover-up just grows and grows and grows. Now, people worship this image that they've created, that even today, people from this community, from this university, they will stand and fight you tooth and nail to deny it in its entirety, because they are so distracted and focused on what they have fallen into believe. No one wants to turn away from all that they hold true and dear, or that they honor and worship. But the devil has revealed all this, and now it's out there for everyone to see. So now you have people on the other side of this who feel so deceived, sounds familiar, so hurt, so misled. The people feel like they have been led astray, because they have. They feel like they have been deceived, because they have. They feel like they have been lied to, because they have. All these things are true. But at some point, many and all need to stop holding these things in such high esteem. This is a object lesson for us all to learn from. Do not ever hold man and things and prestige in such honor that they will have you distracted and not focused on the Heavenly Father Himself. Anyone in that realm of events or chain of events, if they were doing the right thing by the Heavenly Father, they would have done the right thing. But everyone was so concerned about their image, their fame, their popularity, their money, their university, their community, that they felt it best to hide and cover up and what? Wish it go away? But it didn't happen. See, the devil will let it go on, and then he will reveal it all, and many will fall, not just those involved, many will fall. And now this community, this university, has the whole world looking at them like, what are you people all about? Let's look at a scripture right quick. Exodus 20 verse 4. It reads, it says, "Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image, or any likeness of anything that is in the heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth." Okay, that's been violated. They made a statue, and people worship that statue, and they worship the individual behind the statue, and it kept growing, and all the worship and honoring and praising continue on. Scripture says don't do that. This is a perfect example why. You see what happens. Now, verse 5 says, "Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation of them that hate me." This is why people are bowing down, literally and figuratively. They held this man and this statue that represented him in such high esteem that even some today still don't believe he did any wrong. Scripture tells us what we are and are not supposed to be doing, because we get caught up as people. We are only man. We can get caught up in the snares of the enemy. Anyway, I'm not going to drag this on. And understand, it is not an attack on Penn State, the university, the statue, Joe Paterno, or any of that. It is an attack on not being focused and honoring the Father's word and keeping His word. This is just yet another example of what can happen to any and all of us if we don't focus on Him first. We will be deceived, tricked, caught in a snare by the enemy. So, with that being said, Don't allow yourself to become a victim to this. Don't bow down to images and things and worship them and hold them in such high esteem that you put them before all that's sacred and true, the word of the Heavenly Father. And with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful and keep His law. This is 2Bay7. I'm out.